As the sprint for Boston continues on, so does the marathon for Dusseldorf, Germany. Team Liquid looking to dismantle the green wall shot by shot, goal by goal. But if Optic Spring Split has taught us anything, it's that you can't count them out no matter the odds.
The Optic dream was not built overnight, but it's taken a while to get to this point. And my goodness, is this their biggest test yet? Liquid on the field, Optic Gaming. All it takes is one best of five, trying to break through the cracks, but Optic, so much in front of them, so much to prove. And Liquid trying to make a marathon run happen here this weekend.
And so much at stake. You can only hope, if you're an Optic Gaming fan, that they are staying focused and not worrying about the noise outside of the series, what's on the line. Of course, they're aware that they could book their ticket potentially and get that much closer to going to Dusseldorf, Germany. And if they're out, they are eliminated from Worlds. V1 are definitely Optic haters today. But we'll see how this one unfolds. Game number one looks like it's all Team Liquid, starting out with some pressure, taking the midfield boost. The Chronic, we saw some solo plays from him against Elevate. They had a great first series on the day to bounce back from their loss against Complexity. Will they continue it forward if they can get the blocks against Optic?
Keys to victory for Liquid going into this best of five. Neutralize AJ early on and force Optic on those double commits defensively. Yeah. Optic with an impressive 6-2 record in game ones as the Chronic tries to put the first one away, but the defense stands strong and AJ's out on the clear.
And if you want to talk about records, I mean, think about Liquid's record right now against North America. They're 0-4 on LAN this season against North America, and every single series has gone the distance, either to game five or game seven. They just can't figure out how to close, and now they can't figure out how to put an accurate shot on the net that won't get blocked. Meanwhile, AJ, he's figured out the defense, but it's not in time for Reddles as he couldn't recover and just get enough over the ball.
First chance on the striker as AJ got hot early, but for Optic, getting those involved is going to be the task. Trying to get Reddles working through the back line. Physicality is going to be huge as well as we trade possessions. A Chronic wrist shot slaps in. A Chronic for the first.
It's a solo play developed from this awkward rotation from Reddles, and Ato went in for the dunk, expecting Reddles to turn quickly from that corner looking for boost, but nobody was there, and he let it go right into the midfield. Easy shot for a Chronic.
We want to talk about Optic Gaming's record in game one. 6-1 for Liquid, just as good, if not better. Into the corner we go. Starting on the blue half, Optic losing the kickoff, but trying to get their numbers back up early as Oski begins the press in the towel. Think twice about those chances. Rotations begin to flourish. And we see that the pressure from Liquid, so good on the defensive end, doing a nice job of holding that boost as Reddles finds one victim on the opposite end.
And you can already see what Reddles has in mind for this series. The typical rotation for Optic Gaming. I mean, when I think about this squad, I have this image of Reddles forward. Wait, hold on a second. Forget about what I'm imagining, because Team Liquid are in the moment creating some magic.
Peeling and dicing their way into the offensive third as the Chronic found two touches and AJ on the commit.
Man.
Left it up and had to watch that one roll by very quickly. Liquid striking hot twice.
I don't know if it's me underrating or undervaluing a Chronic coming into this major along with everybody else. I mean, we looked at the top 25 players. I'm sure a lot of the community saw that from Johnny Boy, Bates, etc. And a lot of people weren't valuing a Chronic, and he's here to prove some people wrong and earn a spot in maybe the top three.
Contesting on the push, here comes Reddles, the captain of this squad, the IGL, one of the front-facing members of Optic Gaming. Very known for his criticism of his own team.
Wow.
They're not playing
there
up to standards.
Again.
Could stay the same here, as for the moment, it's a bloodbath on the field. Liquid breaking through this green wall.
It's a bloodbath, but the blood is the color of green, because right now the defense bleeding and they can't rotate in time. Defense breaking down awkwardly. Not sure where that third man was for Optic Gaming. Quick rotations and counterattacks out of Liquid caught them with their pants down, and it looks like game one has been a wash so far.
It's been a tough road here for Optic. They bow out in four against Moist yesterday. They come into this lower bracket with their life on the line, the tournament all at stake, and what a save from Magic Bear. You're gonna need two of those to keep Optic involved in this game one, and you're gonna need a counterattack to get yourself out of this pressure.
I mean, they're still involved, but for how long? They're getting suffocated, boost, stolen, demos, left and right, winning challenges. Oski doesn't even get a touch there from AJ, and then the follow-up dunk. Every single 50 going in favor of the blue side, and they're keeping this ball stuck.
Long clear to Atal. More on the cards for Optic Gaming to begin their push. Numbers start to fly in on the spread. 2-1. Good save from Akronic. Dives down and finds his way forward. Buys enough time for a Tau to get comfortable in space, and there we see the right side press with a demo as well. Physicality favoring Liquid early on, and they have found three goals from it. Midfield pressure theirs as well into the offensive third. It's just chip shots and traffic all into the orange side. We go laterally, jet it towards the corner. Akronic re-centers, but AJ denies.
Optic Gaming have been slow due to those demos and this overall aggression and push from Team Liquid. Finding themselves in the midfield, finding a Donkato. Set it up for Akronic, who wants another solo play. This man has been doing so much work. He started against Elevate, and that trend has continued on now in game one, but Ato reminds us just how good he is.
He just punches Optic when they're stuck in the kill box. This is so easy for Liquid, forcing the double commits, forcing
the reset on the backboard.
And the pressure that Optic Gaming can't break out of, it's all of Liquid early on, and for the right reasons, they've kept that running through this lower bracket, and right now they're running through Optic.
Adding a little bit of sauce on the shot too with the reset. So pretty, so fun to watch. And hang on a minute, 37 on the clock. I don't have too much hope for Optic Gaming, but to get on the board, I think, is a good mental break for these boys.
You got to stop the bleeding early. This is still a best of five. You go down 1-0, it doesn't feel like a lot, but it stacks heavily very quickly. Best of seven is coming for the rest of the weekend. For now, Optic have to realign their focus and bring their attention back to the kickoff. 35 seconds is a lot to play through, but they need three goals, and it's going to take a bit of a miracle. Ooh. And a Tau clearing that one away will make it even more difficult.
I'm not sure it's quite possible at this point. You got to regroup, set your sights on game number two, because Team Liquid, they came to play in game number one, and granted, they have been on the main stage today. That might be paying, or at least contributing to their success in game number one. And it's important, Sean, to be comfortable on that stage in the field. In the comms, just getting that first initial series in is huge. And Team Liquid, like I said, comfortable first game win, and they set the pace.
They really did. Liquid's already played today. They had a sweep earlier on against Elevate, 3-0 in our lower round one. This is round two. Optic, of course, coming in a little bit cold, but you have to think just through the scrims, they're feeling good. As you take a quick look at how this one really did play out, it was just a lack of assists all the way across the board. AJ struggling.
AJ struggling to get activated on offense. This is one shot coming out from AJ, which is surprising. Normally, especially coming out of North America, he's the number one shot taker out of that region. In total, I believe it was 309 shots just from the spring split, scoring 91 goals. And here he comes out in game one, one shot on the board. He's not getting activated. The opportunities aren't there, and they need to start cooking.
I mean, one of the things you have to do if you're Liquid coming into this, neutralize AJ early on. You do so successfully in game one. The results follow, 4-0 lead. It didn't look back. It was consistent from Liquid. The pressure was there. And when you lose your primary striker in Optic, defense starts to crumble. The offense doesn't get going. And the pressure that they have to force on themselves to get back upfield, to overcommit, to extend, it's very tough for Optic to break out.
And they couldn't get in the groove. Like I was saying before, I got rudely interrupted by, I believe, Akronic with that lovely goal. When I imagine Optic Gaming, I think of Rettles going for the demo, AJ air dribbling behind the ball, and then Magic Bear holding things down on the defensive side. That's their form. That's what they like to play in. That's where they're comfortable. Obviously, they can rotate and swap positions, but for the most part, that's Optic Gaming to a T. I didn't see any of that. They tried to get in formation. It wasn't working. Maybe game two has a different story.
Forbidden Temple always neutralizes the series or keeps the momentum moving. What do Optic Gaming have in store? Can they bring this one back for Liquid?
Oh, no.
Trying to put the series on match point. And with touches like that from Oski, it's going to be even easier.
Especially with touches like this one from Rettles. Unfortunately, not going the right direction. And it also hits the top corner of the dome. Instead of bouncing out off the backboard, it rolls directly in front of the goal. I don't want to say unfortunate, just a missed touch there from Optic and a slow start in game two.
Picking up where we left off, if you're Liquid. Optic still struggling to get out of the starter's gate. And now they have to stop the bleeding yet again. A 1-0 lead early on. Barely 20 seconds burn here in game two. And Liquid with a lead. And it's another big physical play inside the goal line. AJ will have to find the slow. And Rettles trying to escape with his life, avoiding a demo. Full boost on the sidewall. He's got AJ in the center box, looking for the pass, but it's cut down quickly.
Reminder, this is Optic's hope at making it to Germany and staying alive in that race to get to Dusseldorf. A slow start in game two is rough. I mean, you talk about game one, that's fine. Maybe you can regroup. But things have to change, and they won't right now with Atoh going for demos and deleting you.
Now we gotta run this one back. It looks like a bit of an overextension. Rettles gets a little high five, and the demo that just clears house. I mean, Magic Bear had to fly back, and there's no chance.
The confidence for Atoh to even extend right there. He's all the way in Optic Gaming's half as they're transitioning. He's got confidence that his teammates can get the clears, can find the dribbles, and of course hit the shots. He doesn't need to be passive. And that is huge from Team Liquid, but here's Magic Bear. Gips himself on the board, and Optic Gaming, a little bit of life.
Need a little bit of magic from the kickoff. Huge 50 from AJ that sets it up off the backboard. Magic Bear closes the deal, and they cut the lead to one.
It's about time they get their act together. You don't want to give up more than, you know, a one-goal lead. Bring yourself where you need just one mistake out of Team Liquid, one blunder, and you've got yourself back into the game, equalize things up, and hopefully they find their groove. Chronic alone finds Oski on the ceiling. I mean, this is the confidence that I'm talking about, the positioning, the trust in the teammates from Team Liquid.
And there was the double commit as well towards the backboard that made it more difficult for Optic to restabilize down on their own third. This is where the pressure gets deadly. Liquid can start playing with the numbers here, picking apart on the power play, but AG on the carry, looking for the double tap, will be denied. Here comes Rettles, thinking twice. Left it up to Oski. Does he have enough? No, Rettles collapses, cuts in his rotation, and shuts down the Liquid push.
Rettles wants to get things moving once again. AJ too slow, but does get a demo out of it. Oski, shot on target, but slightly off the crossbar. AJ, what does this man have? Not a double tap. Keeping possession just doesn't seem possible out of Optic Gaming.
Shot after shot, volley after volley, a flurry of trades back and forth, but Liquid have Optic in a chokehold right now. Though it might be a one-goal game, it feels like it's even more.
But you know that Optic Gaming, one demo, one extension forward can change the pace. And the fact that they've just kept it within one is huge. We're now approaching the second half. And things have to change. What will Optic implement? What strategy do they have that we haven't seen and that Liquid haven't seen this series?
Just trying to break out, force Liquid to respect you at the midfield. It's got to be the go-to for Optic, but the memo as of now has been all blue. 2:13 on the clock, plenty of time. Rettles trying to take it away, was looking for the bump. It was close enough, but still, for the moment, Liquid do survive on their counterattack. AJ has plenty of boost.
Rettles took the boost.
And Rettles is hunting, but it goes nowhere.
Rettles is hunting. Indeed, it doesn't go anywhere, but maybe applying the pressure could force a mistake. Magic reset out. Up on top of the corner, AJ fires from the dunk, but it's gonna be difficult to find accuracy. And back towards the other end, Liquid goes, but Rettles, hello, thank you for turning quickly. That's what we need. Optic Gaming have to stay on offense. One goal necessary, double demos, but AJ missed the shot. Rettles gets the dunk and finds the security with AJ's back. That was almost catastrophic, Spaceman.
The Optic van never left. It was reincarnated,
man.
In Rettles
and
AJ upfield. Finally, some physicality, some signs of life from Optic Gaming.
Something about the name AJ. We got AJG coming out here, struggling. AJ couldn't get the shot either. I'm getting flashbacks. This is traumatizing, but somehow Optic neutralized.
Close calls on the backboard. AJ gets it around one, takes a victim with him. Off spawn, Liquid will only have two up. We'll have to play through the power. From the ceiling, Oski the second touch. It's pretty gross. As Optic try to restabilize on the backboard, weathering the shots and the attempts from Liquid that have continued to fly at their heads.
Nice chip shot from Atoh. Keeping the ball in the corner. But we haven't seen a lot of creativity. Liquid, they were fired up in the beginning of this game, flattened out and denied from Optic Gaming. No solo plays, passed through the midfield. We haven't seen a break, a lapse in rotation either. Clean gameplay out of Optic.
And a nice push by Rettles. Got the extra touch on the hood. Was able to extend the play just a bit. Atoh and Rettles both upfield working together, trying to clear each other off and create a space for where their offenses can flourish. From the side wall, Magic Bear hanging back. AJ coming off spawn. He's gonna have to work against Atoh in a one-on-one. AJ will make that catch. Can't pop it over. What a ridiculous 50. Are you kidding? Oski with the 50 of the series.
Absolutely stuffs AJ. dunks over him off the ceiling and brings out the protractor to hit that angle. Ridiculous stuff. 20 seconds to go. Team Liquid just might steal game two.
The biggest kickoff of the tournament for Optic. The momentum on the side of Liquid. And the mechanics have stepped up for Optic. The team play needs to kick into high gear. On the slow touch, AJ.
He could change
in
things.
The works. Moving into the box. There's a bump in the back. AJ still keeps it alive, and it's wide. It was a chance for Optic, but they just can't find the angle. Liquid survive a late push, and they find themselves up 2-0 in a best of five.
And I have no idea how they did survive that. There was a bump play coming out in the final few seconds, and it was a Chronic stuck alone on an island. He had to make the save. I'd love to get another look at his perspective. I think he recovered even on the ground and still got a piece of the ball, denying Magic Bear with a shot. And now Optic Gaming find themselves in the exact same position they did against Moist. They went down 0-2. First two games, lost. They won the third, but at that point, it was too late. Couldn't take the series. Will things change here, Spaceman?
It's always been prevalent for Optic. How many times in their spring regionals, in their runs, have they been down backs against literal wall and found a way to fight back? But Liquid is a very different beast, and this is a very different situation. Their tournament life is on the line here at the Major. For Liquid, they're not going to give you an inch. You have to force the mile out of them. And for Optic, it's going to take a lot more downfield together.
For the Major, for Worlds, so much riding on Optic Gaming in this series as we take a look at OSKI. 1 year, 1 month. I mean, these guys so new to the scene, so fresh, such a young roster, but as much potential as you could see in a team is Team Liquid. And that's not going to scare Optic Gaming. They might be down 0-2, but we remember that reverse sweep best of seven. Anything goes when it's the green wall.
Anything goes at the Major. Optic Gaming need your praise. They need it now. Liquid just trying to close this one away and do so in dominant fashion. Liquid look good, but Optic need to step up. Into game three we go. 5 minutes on the clock.
They need to step up, and they absolutely can. There's no doubt about it in my mind. When their backs are against the wall, they play the best Rocket League. But the pressure is on. Rettles, nice 50-50. They're forced back into their own half. Looks very reminiscent of every single game so far. Stuck in the corners. OSKI getting demos, getting dunked.
Looks like some potential communication issues for the moment for Optic. AJ was hesitant to make that challenge on the 50 in the corner. Had plenty of boost to do so. But as the numbers start to spread, there we go. Space created for OSKI comes off of his own side and takes it away. Liquid finding multiple ways to take away possession from Optic and keep it contested through the corner. The mechanics working as intended before AJ finds the interception.
OSKI from the backboard. Atoh found the demo. The pressure mounting for Team Liquid. Another demo. Atoh just doesn't stop. Manz is relentless with his aggression. And OSKI finds himself on the transition.
And Magic Bear was overextending upfield to find boost. You need someone from Optic to meet the midfield pressure and keep the ball away from Liquid. You can't afford just to have one man out every single time. Play a two-on-two upfield, you're gonna lose it.
Oh, there's Rettles hunting. Classic playstyle. Magic Bear also gets the bump. A Chronic knocked out of the way. And here comes Optic.
In transition, it all clicks together. OSKI gives away possession. AJ on the slow touch. Magic Bear cleans house. The punch through and the 1-0 lead finally. Some smiles in those face cams as Optic are on the board.
And the thing about a demo-heavy playstyle is once you start to incorporate more demos and you're finding contact with players, it gets that much easier to keep getting demos because they're knocked out of rotation. AJ, hello.
Subtle, simple, graceful Baryshnikov from AJ. The catch, where are you going, young one?
Oh man, and the approach too from a Chronic. Very confusing way, didn't know how to tackle him. And you just get embarrassed. This is the biggest lead we've ever seen from Optic in this series. Now they gotta hold on.
It's gonna take a lot more than two goals to keep Liquid at bay. That's why you got the green wall.
That's right.
3 minutes on the clock. Two of it been successful for Optic. Liquid will try to find something at that midfield. Contest continue, and AJ once again starting to get a little bit physical, starting to win more of those 50s and set up his teammates, forcing the double commits on the goal
line
for Liquid, and that shot from Reynolds is absolutely beautiful.
And this whole movement started with AJ staying patient behind the ball, having the vision of where Team Liquid wanted to move out of their own half. That set up the challenges to move forward. Things getting picked up out of Optic Gaming. Reynolds, the strike is just as perfect as could be. And this is what we wanted to see if you're a fan of Optic Gaming. They took game three down against Moist, and it looks like they might do the same thing here against Team Liquid. Now they've got to carry it throughout the whole series and the second half of this one.
Two misses on the touch for AJ, a couple of defensive woes for Optic, but they start to stabilize back to the midfield. And Oski creating absolutely pandemonium as Magic Bear finds two, but they can't convert. Back to full strength for Liquid, 3v3 we go. A lot of time healed here still for Liquid. And what can they make of it?
They've got a hill to climb, Spaceman. And Reynolds, he's staying behind the ball, getting patient. This is everything you could have asked for. Just want to run that clock down. Don't let Team Liquid get going because it can get dangerous. More demos coming out, and they're finding their groove. That's what I'm talking about, Spaceman. It's a team that starts to get demos, throws the other team off,
yeah,
and it becomes that much easier. I mean, you break the rotation once, and they're going to lag a little bit to find that rhythm again. Makes it that much easier.
The demos are great, but where's the conversion downfield? You need that collateral for Optic to start kicking in. Yeah. You can't afford to fight the demos. Where are the dividends? They have to pay off somewhere.
They've definitely shown that in this game, at least, when they do find demos, moving downfield that has been properly timed, where they walk away with three goals and nothing for Team Liquid.
Fighting for their tournament life. And this major means everything for both teams. Worlds on the line, sure, but more than that, proof of concept this late in the season. Reynolds at the midfield. Possession there to Liquid. Natal will now get his call, thinking about the pass. Like the idea from Liquid moving up slowly but surely, finding some space.
It's a grounded approach from Liquid, more dribbles than we've seen in quite some time. I think they are more dominant in the air. The faster you can get this ball up, the better for Team Liquid. A chronic, good speed. Toe looking for the double, but AJ had him red. Called his bluff, and this has been a defensive showing with that resurgence on offense out of Optic.
And that's what they've needed, to stand strong on the defensive end into the orange half yet again. What feels like the last 2 minutes of all of Liquid pressure. A towel somehow sneaks his way around. Center box for Liquid. Back out to the midfield. Now it's a foot race. Reynolds has to get there in time. He will. Big shot. Quick save. Atau into the corner. Back to the center box. Struggling as they might be, AJ is there to capitalize for a lead up.
And look at how quickly Reynolds was to get down the other side of the field. Everybody out of Liquid is scrambling. Can't find rotations. And AJ has a pretty sight at a free net. 16 seconds on the clock. Optic Gaming, of course they're not out.
They fight tooth and nail all the way down to the end, but Liquid are not out of it by any stretch. It's going to be a long series. And maybe it goes the distance. But as this one stands for the moment, Optic fight for another game, up 4-0. They'll close it at that. And we have ourselves a 2-1 lead for Liquid.
And they are faced with, for the first time, a challenge. Liquid 3-0'd Elevate, and we're smooth sailing for most of that series. Coming out here against Optic Gaming, they get shut out 4-0. And that's got to sting a little bit, but with these guys, of course, the maturity, they've had experience. This is not their first LAN anymore. They might be a young team, but those three players, they have what it takes to bounce back, Spaceman.
Optic close to putting up around 2 goals per game over the spring split as a whole. So they're going to get their shots. They're going to get their chances.
Yeah.
And as Liquid come into this knowing that, it's been a relentless amount of pressure from Liquid, but Optic have stood strong.
And here comes AJ. I mean, this man had a hat trick in this game alone. We were talking about that, how reliant they are in this Mobile One High Performance Replay on AJ. He has to get involved. He was getting denied, absolutely shut out in the first 2 games, couldn't do anything. He comes through, the demos are syncing with when he's behind the ball, and Optic Gaming flourish.
We're bringing back the Batmobile, like the mullet of the RLCS.
No, he's not on the Batmobile anymore.
He wants to play the Batmobile.
It's a fun fact.
I respect
I don't understand that fun fact. It said he wants to play the Batmobile, And that's what we got, I believe, in the first series with Team Liquid. Listen, against Complexity. Ghost on the Batmobile since.
All I'm saying is I have not seen a Tao and Batman in the same room. So I don't know. I don't know what that means. Imagine a Tao protecting Gotham as they try to protect
He's got a full-time job already in Rocket League, okay? I don't think you can protect Gotham at the same time. And that's why he's not on the Batmobile. The Fennec trying to pave a way for Liquid. Still on match point on knocking Optic Gaming out of the tournament.
All it takes is 5 minutes of good Rocket League from Liquid, and they keep on their campaign here at the Major. Optic try to continue their press and fight for more time. Very early on, a couple of demos, but nothing too crazy as the Chronic gets a little bit dicey on the backboard and a couple of bumps through the corner, but pressure still here for Liquid.
Chronic looking for a little bit of a scoop. It did look promising. Creativity from Team Liquid that we didn't get in the last game. So, flip reset, looking for a stuff on AJ. Oski already got a nice dunk in game number two, I believe. Want to continue the theme. Full boost for Oski as he transitions out.
We've seen the demos from Reddles. We've seen the aerial plays and pressure from AJ. Waiting for Magic Bear to start getting his number upfield as well. When the full force of Optic is clicking, they're very tough to beat, but Liquid have the mechanics to get it done.
This is scary stuff. Liquid have been taking the corner boost. I see a Chronic right now on the cam, taking the corner of Optic, depleting their boost tanks. But in the last game, that wasn't enough. There's got to be something else, another step, layers to this rotation to put them on the board and get the lead.
It's the same pressure we saw back just a game ago. Liquid are not letting up. Pedal pushed all the way down. Here comes Optic into the blue half. Center back out. It'll be handled by Liquid appropriately. They'll get out on the counterattack quickly, diced up and deleted. Oski to the ceiling. One bump from a Chronic. A toe in the backboard. Off the crossbar. No, a little bit too high. And back out in transition we go. So we're just trading possessions here early on. Not a lot of fanfare to start here in game four.
I mean, if you can even call Optic Gaming's transitions a form of possession right now, they're just getting out to relieve whatever this is from Team Liquid, the starvation. Looks like neither team can buy a goal, but Team Liquid certainly has all the possession, and there's some space given to Magic Bear. This is their one opportunity, could be a good chance. Off the backboard, where's AJ? He's flying through, but it's a weak shot, and a Chronic can get behind it.
Scrambling offense, but better defense for the moment. 2 minutes, some odd change burned. Still looking for our first goal here. As Liquid handle the pressure start, to the midfield we go. Mateo gonna fly through. Missing a couple of touches. AJ still looking for possession. Hits the reset, tries to find the touch, but nobody else is around for Liquid.
Things get scary once you see Liquid put up so many shots with zero goals.
Oh,
you remember what
man.
Happened against Complexity? And Reddles through the demos paves away.
This is a fake and a half from AJ. My goodness, that had to cover a lot of ground and a lot of trust from Optic. And Liquid had no idea how to respond.
I mean, we just passed the 4th of July. I feel like instead of having a fireworks show, we could have just put Optic Gaming on a big screen with Rocket League and have them go for demos. It would be just as beautiful, and Reddles would get just as many demos as every single firework we've ever seen, and he continues to do so. That man, so physical on the pitch.
It might come down to a one-goal game, but Liquid try to turn the tides here. Beautiful step back out of the box as a Chronic. Dangerous off the crossbar. Popped high and taken away. AJ thinking about boost. Oski on the center. Looking for the pass. Second touch is ridiculous. A Chronic waiting for his chance, but another huge 50 from AJ.
Team Liquid, they're swarming around Optic Gaming, and it's a free one. The transition. They stay on defense. They bait in Liquid, and then they catch him all on the other side with a free net to shoot at.
It feels like we've been waiting for AJ to get released into this series, and finally the transition works. And Optic have a two-goal lead on Coliseum, fighting for Champions Field for Liquid. So much pressure, so many shots, but not a lot of interconnectivity. And they've been struggling to find one another upfield.
And that's tilting. I feel like it's also one of the hardest aspects of this game to not get too desperate. If you have all this possession, all of these shot space, man, you get frustrated. You're wondering, why are we not breaking through the defense? It feels like we should be winning. So you get too risky, you overextend, you rotate too far forward, and that's exactly what's happening to Team Liquid.
AJ gives it back to Akronic. There's Oski inside the box, and it's a beautiful touch and a wonderful pass. We cut the lead to one.
Finally, the drought is ended, and Oski started with a fake. Ato applies the pressure. AJ has to go for the 50, and Oski rotates back in, cuts in front of the goalkeeper, and brings us within one.
It could all come down to the final minute. Off the kickoff. They're going to have their first touch. Optic do find the touch. And it slowly careens into the corner. Oski and Akronic trying to work together in tandem. And he gets it around one. Oh, back to center. Great stop.
Cross
and there
bar.
Goes
what?
Liquid off the board.
What?
No. How does this happen? Every time Liquid have something moving upfield, something goes wrong. And Optic are able to escape.
How
now it's
this
up to Reynolds onto the back wall. Can Reynolds get there in time? Yes. But to center field we go. And somehow, someway, Liquid haven't scored.
I think Oski and Ato must have gotten over each other in rotation, stepping on each other's toes, and now they find themselves 30 seconds remaining, down by two.
Disaster strikes at the worst time for Liquid. If you thought it was bad yesterday, add this one to the tally as well. 3-1 Optic, 28 seconds away from game five, and a reverse sweep in the cards for Liquid, the kickoff that matters most.
Another reverse sweep. How many times can they keep getting away with this? Optic Gaming, we've got one more game so long as Liquid don't bring us within one and give us a little ounce of hope in game number four. Good 50-50 out of Reynolds. 10 seconds on the clock. Liquid have to score now. They get a demo. This could be risky. Akronic back to the midfield. Oski gets the shot. It's too weak. And Reynolds will confirm a game number five.
Together they stand, together they fall. The Champions Field goes the green wall. Liquid backs against it. Optic on the reverse sweep. Is it possible? One for the road, sure. But we got game five coming up.
It's not enough. And you think what could have happened if you didn't get mixed up? I cannot keep replaying these mistakes in my head. They had the open shot. They worked for it, Spaceman. Right on top of each other. And one took it away. I'm not even sure. I think it was Ato and Oski. They didn't know who was going for the shot. And that's going to be ringing in your heads in game five.
The adjustments from Optic, the trust upfield. Finally, they're making those clean touches.
Yes.
They're winning the 50s.
Yes.
AJ getting that rebound on defense and finding Reynolds upfield, stealing that boost for Magic Bear. The connections have been there for Optic late in this series. As you see on our Mobile One High Performance replay, it was pressure consistent for Liquid.
Yeah.
But they just struggled on the accuracy, and it bites them in the end.
Consistent for Liquid. But the accuracy is what you need. It doesn't matter how many shots. What's important is finding the execution. And we were reminded of that yesterday, just how important it is to hit your shots when given the opportunity. And here we go into game five. If you're a Liquid fan, you can only hope that it's always darkest before the dawn. But right now, Optic Gaming, their wall is just forcing the dawn right now. The shadow, you can't get out of it.
Brick by brick. As the lights loom over Champions Field, and Optic on the verge of a reverse sweep, keeping their Boston major hopes alive. Do they have enough? One more match to decide it all.
Magic Bear back to the corner, and we're going to start right where things left off, Spaceman, in the defensive half of Optic Gaming, and they're looking for a transition, a rotation out. They're laying down little traps in the midfield. You don't see three players, even one player in the midfield waiting for a challenge. Magic Bear wants to get a demo, moving back. And it's all about the transition game. Will Team Liquid continue to push forward when they shouldn't?
It's patience on the sidewall, on the backboard. Optic looking for spaces where they can work through the crease. Liquid have to start meeting these challenges in the air as Atal will get that up in time and punch it to the opposite corner. AJ right back, ping pong, here we go. Almost a minute burn here in game five. It's been all the pressure from Optic, but for Liquid on the slow, they're gonna have to start getting those mechanics out and ready, available.
AJ, this is the player that has to pop off, AJ. He had a hat trick in game number three, two goals in game number four. What is his performance in game number five? It's crucial to Optic Gaming taking this win and securing a reverse sweep.
Oski sitting back in the net. Ato will try to move up. Gonna have to fight against Reynolds for this possession. Keeps it on the ground. Great pass to Oski. That is beautiful from Liquid.
Beautiful indeed. And it's Ato waiting on Reynolds. Look at the patience. He hit the brakes on the sidewall. and had everything predicted. He opted the time machine and knew where Reynolds was going
to
go.
It's the timing. They wait, and they get Optic to bite on the double commit. They did that in game one. It gave them the lead, and they have struggled to keep that consistent. Optic now have to respond.
And we have to be reminded again, Team Liquid are 0-4 against NA this season on LAN. Every single time they've lost against North America, it has been on Game 5 and Game 7. This is an opportunity to break that curse.
Huge demos in the corner. Can Optic convert? But headhunters for the moment. A couple of bumps, friendly fire, a Tau. Juggling, putting
Flippery
it away,
has
the space, and a huge save from Magic Bear. Steps up in big clutch time.
And he kept the boost, kept the flick, got the save. Here comes AJ behind the ball, looking for an air dribble. Magic Bear sneaks in to get a shot. It's a bit cheeky, but it's not enough.
Still big 50s here from Optic. Liquid can't afford to get lackadaisical.
Passed over. Reddle,
almost found the redirect, still alive. The boys are pushed up. Magic Bear off the post.
God.
Getting a taste of the Liquid medicine here in Champions Field.
Oh, I don't know who's Liquid and who's Optic at this point. They are playing the same role. Everybody wants to hit the post. Everybody wants to hit the crossbar. Who can push it past the goal line in Game 5? It's only been Liquid.
The demos aren't there in the backline, but here they come.
Magic
Numbers go up, and it's a score. Protocol. AJ scores, and it's tied 1-1.
Send in the cavalry. Here comes two players. Reynolds gets a demo behind the ball. Magic Bear moves forward, knocks the Chronic out the way, and tie us up.
When you need it most, Optic have an answer. Liquid putting all of their eggs in one bucket. Time to pour it on the green wall. A response needs to come through. With plenty of time on Champions Field, the pressure mounts and Oski's in the air.
Tournament life on the line for Liquid and Optic Gaming. Germany on the line for only Optic Gaming. V1 shaking right now watching this series unfold. There is so much riding on who's going to take this win, and Ato wants to secure it for his team.
Rattle's got to be careful. He's the only one back. AJ's getting aggressive. Clean touches are the motto for Optic right now. For Liquid, continue this pressure at the midfield. Win these 50s, and you have a chance. And so far, it's been all of the green wall.
Austin
looking for a Chronic, cut down by Magic Bear. Reynolds thinking twice on the back wall. He's stuck,
and
it's four down. It's still alive. Here comes the recovery. Big demo there from Liquid, but Magic Bear begins his press. Trying to move upfield, the cavalry gets called in, and the Chronic's the only one up.
He's
got two members in front.
He's got a double.
And plenty on the
Where's
pitch.
The
Anybody else around? No. Liquid slow to the touch, but here comes more pressure, and the rotation through the midfield is so easy. Liquid on the slow, but Optic with the save.
Liquid heating up every shot. Looks to be top-notch quality. When are we going to get something that's just below the crossbar? This could be it. It is, and it's a Chronic.
If you give them enough time, they're going to will it through. A disgusting cut.
Oh, yeah, that pass. Come on. Now that's a clutch play.
2-1.
Team Liquid, this is the curse that they want to get out of. They want to beat their first North American team on LAN this season. And it might be Optic Gaming. Final minute to go. Is it the final dagger? No, it's not. Optic Gaming still alive.
They have to find a way to clear this out. Liquid, so powerful in these touches downfield, connecting to one another. The rhythms are there. The cadence has been kicked up into a different gear. And Liquid are putting Optic away. Pressure mounts on the orange side from the ceiling. Magic Bear will get the call.
But you never know what can happen with Optic Gaming. They need to throw caution to the wind and send everybody forward again. Will it be that transition? Can they bait in Team Liquid, staying on defense and have everybody push forward? 18 seconds to go.
There's a bump from Reynolds, keeps it on the ground. Another one from AJ, numbers are up. Optic have to begin. Here comes Magic Bear, cleared away, and a shovel pass to Atau. Into the midfield, the must-be to kill time.
Over to Reynolds.
Gonna pop it high. Optic need a miracle from the ceiling. Liquid putting it on death's door.
It's still up.
Is it enough? Optic trying to keep it alive, and it will not happen. Liquid survive in 5, and they knock Optic out of the tournament.
Team Liquid, they've done it. They smack North America out of this tournament. Optic Gaming, what a series we got. Action-packed. We thought it was going to be another one of those reverse sweeps from the green wall. And I don't know what's better. I mean, that was a nail-biter of a series. Game five could have gone either way. Looking for transitions and the hands and the face with what was on the line for that match for Optic Gaming. That stings.
That is a loss that Optic will feel for a very, very long time. This team that had so much riding on their shoulders, how much they proved during the spring, the turnaround that was immaculate in North America, to make it to this point, to be so close, to finally get to Champions Field, and you feel like the momentum's on their side.
I mean,
literally everything was riding itself. And yet again, look, Liquid are just that good. Every time you want to count them out, you pay for it.
And you also have to give credit for Liquid to keep fighting in this series. I mean, they've already made it to Germany. They've had good runs at a major this season, but that is how hungry this young squad is. I remember we listened to the interview with Aquanic saying how badly he wants to win this major, and he wants to claim Boston for Team Liquid.
Liquid sweep their way through Elevate and Lore round one. They go to Champions Field and handle business as well here in round two.
Oh, man.
And they keep their hopes alive. A lower bracket run that would be as impressive as anything you'll ever see, but they keep it going series one by one, one at a time. And my goodness, for Optic, you know, positives for sure, but yeah. I know for the boys, a disappointing result.
It's disappointing, but they can still be proud of their season, of their split, but there's more left in store for Team Liquid. And I think we got the birthday boy on the stage again with Subi.
That's right, Turtle. I'm up here with Aquanic, and Aquanic is surviving a possible reverse sweep, the best birthday present you can get.
Yeah, definitely. We almost got reverse swept. I mean, you could have swept them as well, but it is what it is.
No, you bring that up because it seemed like when you guys started off game one, like you wanted to make a statement. The offense immediately started. The shots immediately were there. What was that statement you guys wanted to come out and make to Optic Gaming?
I think we just wanted to play our game. Like, we have a strategy that we tried to work with other teams, like, and yeah, we just focused on it.
Well, you guys have officially punched your ticket once again into the top eight. It just seems like a formality at this point that Team Liquid's gonna be top eight. You're gonna be going up against either SSG or Gen G. Do either of those teams scare you? And if not, are there any teams at this LAN that you wanna potentially avoid?
Nah, none of them scare us. And I don't think there are teams that we wanna avoid because we don't really care who we play.
Now, love the confidence. It's something you always bring onto the field. And with that also comes a lot of responsibility. You're an inspiration to so many young players out there. When you were coming up, who was that inspirational player for you?
I think everyone knows the answer, but it was Justin, definitely.
Now, what about that obviously the flashy plays, he had the mechanics, but was there anything in particular that stood out to you that you wanted to replicate anytime that you took this stage?
I think it was like, I used to start like watching his streams because the way he moved his car, the way he did his goals. And then, yeah, I just wanted to be a pro just like him.
Well, you're a pro just like him, and you are continuing to make waves and continuing to make statements. But what's your message to all those young kids out there that are grinding Rocket League, trying to put themselves in your shoes one day?
I think is that I know it might be really hard, but you cannot give up, because if you do, then you're never going to reach where we are right now.
Well, once again, Aquanic, happy birthday. Glad you get to represent Team Liquid up on this stage, and Team Liquid finally get that monkey off their back and take down North America.